G'day everyone, Alex from Paperform here. Now today I'm going to share with you how you can easily connect your Paperform with your Google Sheets to automatically update rows with submission data. Let's check it out. With the Paperform direct integration, you can directly connect your Google Sheet and add rows when your form is submitted. Keeping your spreadsheet up to date is incredibly easy. Here we have a simple form that prompts a submitter to provide basic details. When the submitter completes the form and hits that submit button, I want the submission data to automatically populate my Google Sheet. So, from the form editor, navigate to After Submission Integrations and Webhooks. Underneath Direct Integrations, select Google Sheets, then select from the list of possible actions. I'm going to select Add Row to Sheet. You'll then be directed to the integration setup, where firstly you'll be prompted to add your Google Sheet account or Google account. So once you've logged in and provided permission for the connection, it's time to set up the integration. Now you'll need to choose which drive your sheet resides within. I'm going to select don't use a specific drive, which will show all Google Sheets that reside within my account. Next, you'll need to select the sheet you wish to connect to your form. So I'll select that from the drop down. Then you'll need to select the worksheet that you want to add a row to. So I'm going to select my worksheet there. And once this is completed, you'll notice that the columns in the selected worksheet have become visible. Note that you must already have columns within that worksheet because in creating this integration, it's not going to automatically create columns. All right, now it's time to map which question fields from my form are going to populate which columns within my Google worksheet. So you can manually type a option or a value just like there, but that's not going to make much sense. Instead, what you want to do is select the icon you see here to the right of the input. And what that's going to do is open up a drop-down menu of all the possible questions within your form. So I have the name column here, so I'm going to select the name question field. Now, when a submitter responds or completes my form, it's going to populate the column name with their response to the name question field. Moving along, I'll then select the email question field for the email column and so on and so forth. Once you've finished configuring the integration, it's time to send a test. But before you run a test, you'll need to ensure that you've completed a test submission of your form so that Paperform can test a connection with real data. Once you're happy with the setup, it's time to select send test. And voila, there we have it, a success. So if we jump into our Google worksheet, we'll see that a new row has been successfully added. Jumping back into the integration setup, you're happy with your setup, all you need to do is hit finish setup. So we'll select that there and voila, you're done. Now every time your form is submitted, it will now add a row to your Google Sheet. All right, if at any time you want to turn off that integration, you can do so here. And you also have the ability to edit, delete, duplicate, and even look at the history of that integration's actions. Well, that's it. I hope it's been a helpful video. And if it has, make sure to hit the thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for everything Paperform. Good luck and have fun creating.